Ladies and gentlemen, before we formally begin, I suppose we should introduce you to the woman who taught these girls how to do this. Her name is Mary Cody, and I'd like to ask her to stand. I know she's out there somewhere. I did hear something about 6 o'clock in the morning at the school teaching 19 girls to line dance. So, thanks, Mary. Good evening. My name is Dan Barber. Along with the 1993 Miss Hudson Court, we will be serving as Masters of Ceremonies. The 19 candidates and the rest of the Hudson Area JCs welcome you to the 1994 Miss Hudson Pageant, as you just witnessed, a little bit country. Our first order of business tonight will be the introduction of the three judges. The three judges met with each of the candidates today for their personal interview. Our first judge, Darlene Walker, and I'd like her to stand, please, is the owner of the Baldwin A&W restaurant. Because of the restaurant business, she has ample opportunity to meet and deal with teenage girls. She enjoys working with them and tries to keep them going in the right direction. She was the originator of the Baldwin pageant and has judged several area pageants in the past. Welcome and thank you, Darlene Walker. Our next two judges are a husband and wife team. Tom and Joellen Schumacher are also from Baldwin. He is an attorney and she is a domestic coordinator. I'd like to ask them to stand if they would. They have three boys and one girl and are family oriented. They enjoy golfing, running, biking, and cross-country skiing. They try to find time for a little rest and relaxation, which may be difficult with four children. Welcome and thank you, Tom and Joellen Schumacher. Our pianist that you heard earlier for this evening is Mary Post. She has been playing piano since grade school. She graduated from the University of Iowa. Mary has been teaching private piano lessons for 16 years and is a member of the National, State, and St. Croix Valley Music Teachers Association. Mary taught elementary music for 5 years. She is an organist and accompanist with the United Methodist Church in Hudson. Mary is volunteer coordinator at the Christian Community Home. Mary and her husband Peter are the parents of Brian, 15, and Diana, 12. In her free time, Mary enjoys camping, gardening, skiing, and biking. Thank you, Mary. At this time, I will introduce our two escorts for the evening. The gentlemen were chosen by the Queen candidates, which makes this a very special honor. Andy Heiser is a senior at Hudson High School. He's on the varsity hockey team, where he's not playing hockey. His future plans are to attend the University of St. Thomas and major in business. Troy Kinsey plays varsity baseball for Hudson High School. He's employed at Taco Bell. In his spare time, he enjoys skiing, football, baseball, and spending time with his friends. His plans for the future include attending technical college to become a machinist. At this time, I would like to acknowledge the pageant committee who have spent countless hours orchestrating this pageant. Jane Wang, Lori Meyer, Chris Olson, Ken and Leah Merchek, Daryl and Katie Jones, and co-chairman Trish Johnson. Thank you to this committee and the other Hudson area JCs involved in the pageant. The MCs for the style show and the talent show this evening will be the 1993 Miss Hudson royalty, beginning with second princess Elizabeth Belknap. Elizabeth is currently working to save money to go to school next fall for a pre-law degree at UW River Falls. On the weekends, Elizabeth enjoys being with friends. It is my pleasure to introduce second princess Elizabeth Belknap.
Candidate. straight as a great addition to any summer wardrobe. Under it, she wears a cotton t-shirt, and on the bottom, she has navy jean shorts. Thank you, Stacy. She wears a bodysuit. The colors look great with the denim shorts. This is a definite must-have for any summer wardrobe. Thank you, Jessica.
T-shirt. darker green denim shorts coordinate with a trim on a dress. The back laces up for a perfect fit. She accents her dress with a black choker necklace.
In the school music department and in the choir at church. He is also in the St. Croix Valley Honors Choir and plans on a minor in the music field. Please welcome Brian Buser and Chris Hammerbeck.
Story you wanna know. drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. I got the routine to drop another nickel in the machine. I wish you would make the music dreamy and sad. Could tell you a lot, but you've got to be truly a gold. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. Now you might know it, but buddy, I'm kind of poet, and I got a lot of things to say. And when I'm gloomy, you simply gotta listen to me until it's talked all the way. Well, that's how it goes. And Joe, I know you're getting anxious to close. So thanks for the cheer. I hope you didn't mind my bending your ear. This torch that I found, it must be drowned, or it soon might explode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. That long, long road.
Thank you.
forward to hearing you again this evening. Now that you have met the 1994 candidates, they have selected a talent of their choice to share with you. The talent selected by the candidates dictated the order in which they will appear to you this evening. Tonight's talents are varied from poetry to gymnastics, and I'm sure you'll enjoy them all. Our first candidate is Nicole Yonash. She's going to be dancing tonight. She's been dancing for 10 years, 7 years in club dancing and 3 years dancing with the Hudson Radiators. Nicole has won regional dance awards and placed with the dance line. Ladies and gentlemen, Nicole Yonash. Gymnastics for 10 years. She is currently on the high school team, and tonight she is doing part of her floor team for us.
Thank you.
Okay. The next candidate is Erin Rutten. Erin really enjoys dancing. That's why she's been doing it for 7 years. The past 3 years, she's been dancing with the Larkin Dance Studio in the cities. Erin was also on the radio dance line her sophomore year. Tonight, we're fortunate enough to get a peek at some of Erin's talent.
Now it's time to get ready. How time flies. What if my dress is just not the right size? My hair, should I put it up or wear it down? Or maybe I should just dye it brown? This is it, my interview time. Why do I think my makeup feels like slime? As I'm in the car, I have a great fear. Will people just go by and jeer? Now here I am, I've made it this far. But when I walked on stage, why did my heels feel like they were coated with tar? Boy, what a mess! How can I stand all this stress? They say it's time for the line dance now. I hope I can get through it without stumbling somehow. A style show. Now that sounds like fun. But if I model the shorts outfit, I should really get some sun. Oh no, what's this? I look in the mirror and I see a big zit, but it's gonna take more than this to make me quit. Now look, just relax. Things aren't so bad. Why should I have any reason to be sad? Preparing for this pageant has really been fun, and I know I'll be glad I was in it when all is said and done.
Lisa Simpson is candidate number 5. for 3 years. Lisa also has competed at both Music Festival in River Falls and Wisconsin Music Teachers Competition. Lisa loves to sing. She says it's a way for her to get away and relax. Here's Lisa Simpson singing a Mary Poppins melody.
Our next candidates are Desiree Moore and Holly Kramer. Desiree and Holly had a little problem deciding what to do, but great friends can always find something, right?
Come with great ease.
But as the day grew near, we didn't know what to do.
So we made a list of talents and came up with a million and two.
Number one on the list was the gift of dance. Busted a move, we thought, yeah, fat chance. Our spirits were low, our outlook was bad. We realized our dance looked a little bit sad. Okay, Dad, let's move on. What's the next category?
You'll like this one, trust me, you won't be sorry.
We moved on the list to the very next thing.
We thought, we have the talent to sin. Singing bit a shot next time. We thought we'd stick with music, just in a different way.
This one for sure would make the judges' day.
So we dug and we found our recorders from fifth grade.
Hey there, Holly, we got this one made.
So we decided to leave our recorders behind. Our choices were slimming and our options were few.
We thought we could juggle,
but that just wouldn't do. But after we put our heads together, are you ready? Jump back.
We realized that art was our only true knack.
But what could you do? Pull out a sketchbook and easel?
No way, that'd be tedious and you'd look like such a weasel.
Everyone has a talent hidden deep down inside.
Some may shine bright while others may hide.
But if you dig and you look and you search really hard,
you might find you're good at baseball or can do a trick with a card.
We thanks for your patience in our talent session.
But we have to go now. We have a banjo lesson.
She has always enjoyed singing since she was very young. She was in choir throughout her sophomore year, participated in solo and ensemble contests, and has sung solos at choir concerts as well. Stacy would like to give a special thank you tonight to Mr. Dan Baumgartner, who arranged and performed her music.
I
the flute. Britt has played the flute for 6 years and is in the band at Hudson Senior High School. She has participated in both solo ensemble and band concerts. She would like to thank her accompanist tonight, Jan Frederick.
Thursday will be Jessica Aspie. She'll be doing a reading. After spending time in the South, Jessica learned that all people do not talk the same way. She will entertain us with a performance on how to speak Southern.
Webster's Dictionary defines folklore as traditional customs, beliefs, tales, or sayings preserved orally among a people. Therefore, words, tales, and sayings become an important reflection of all people as they are passed down through generations. Liberties are sometimes taken with the King's English in these sayings, but they are nevertheless expressive and meaningful. If you can't stand the heat, you better get out of the kitchen, is well known. The blend of culture through generations has rendered a diverse lifestyle that is mirrored in the Southern language, a language that is filled with words and sayings which give picturesque and many times humorous interpretations. Words and sayings seem almost endless in number, but only a few are included here. Some may be used in other locales and have a different or similar meaning, but based on my observations and conversations with my friends in South Carolina, where I lived for a spell, I pass them on to you. If I aim to attend the dinner on the ground, I might be planning to take a cover, as it's Irish. More quickly stated, when I go to the picnic, take a jacket because it's cold. If someone was coming directly, it could be in a little while or a couple of weeks. To be biggity is to be vain, spoon-fed is pampered, chunk is to throw away, and diddle-um squat is worth nothing, and to fall off is to lose weight. Instead of hi or hello, you draw hey for a greeting, which is usually followed by honey, which is a term widely used by female personnel. Much obliged, plain possum, po, reckon, shut mouth, sorry, and y'all are the most used terms in conversations. If you're asleep at the savage, you're not paying attention. Can't come it means you don't like it. After eating cold coon collards, potluck, you're either chunked full or full as a tick. If you're industrious, you are busy as a stump-tailed cow in fly time. If you had a bait, then go ahead and get down the country, which is when you had enough, and give them a piece of your mind. Gone back on your raisin is to deny your heritage, which usually has been hard down good. My personal favorite was being told to heist my carcass to its majestic heights, to stand up and be noticed. The nicest compliment I received in the South was that I was as pretty as a speckled pup under a red wagon with legs like a Tennessee walking horse. Signs of nature and omens telling of future events and happenings are deeply rooted in Southern folklore, such as a rooster crowing at midnight foretells bad luck. A rabbit's foot brings good luck if it comes from the left hind leg of a graveyard hare. To drop a dish rag might mean company is coming and they are hungry, so you may need to put the little pot in the big pot. Well, I do declare, it was good of you to listen for a spell on me talking about my experience in Southern talk. Today we need to mend fences and fertilize friendships throughout this country. If you have been plowing in new ground, I hope that you are chocked full of my little old words and sayings. For those who aren't familiar stomping ground, put another light in the fire. For now, I'll put the chairs in the wagons and say so long. Just remember, when you're up to your tail in alligators, you forget the object was to drain the swamp. Thank y'all.
Our next candidate is Karen Sales. Karen has played the piano for 10 years. She has participated in the Iowa Music Teacher Association for 3 years and the Music Festival for 9. In this time, she has received 3 trophies, 7 superior ratings, and 2 excellent ratings. Thank you.
Next, we have Mary Rogers, Laura Brown, and Jody Johnson. Tonight, they're going to lip sync. They chose to lip sync because it fits their personalities. They enjoy singing and having fun to pop music in the car. They will be lip syncing Back in My Arms Again, Stop in the Name of Love, and Baby Love. The poem she chose to read tonight was given to her by her great aunt Norma Jean when she turned 16. It has sentimental value. It is titled 16.
She is 16. She is...
She is 16 and as beautiful as dawn. I make no prayer to stay her hour of living. This I cannot ask of you, to spare her loss and pain of joy and giving. To hold the petal bud, the drop of dew, and keep her lovely with eternal youth. In days that weave a careless fantasy, I would not rob her of the thorns of truth. For sorrow deeply pays for ecstasy. I do not pray that early love be kind to her. I know how lesser love prepared the youthful heart and disciplined the mind for one great love the heavens learn to share. Just this I ask to be retained complete, this bit of youth when years have made her wise. Let no earthly thing defeat the eagerness for life within her eyes.
For many years. Beth has competed in the WNTA and solo ensemble competitions in the past. She started playing around the age of 5. Duets are what she enjoys playing most.
Thank you.
and our final candidate is Jessica Larkin. Jessica chose to sing. She is involved with the choirs at school and will be involved with the Honors Choir at the University of River Falls. The song tonight is a semi-country ballad titled In This Life.
Short 15-minute intermission so that you can get up and stretch your legs. There are some light refreshments being served upstairs in the river on the conference hall of World Nations. For those of you interested, the Green Bay... sit back in your chairs, try and relax, and for the remainder of the pageant, I do know of 19 very nervous girls in the back right now. With us tonight, we have some visiting royalty from area towns and villages, Dan O'Connell. He made it a point that I know that it's the village of North Hudson, and I've lived there for 26 years. I'm going to ask them all to come up as one group, and we'll make a big line of visiting royalty across the stage, and one representative from each town and village is going to step to the microphone, introduce their court, and when their festival is this year. Come on over. I think we'll start way down at the far end over there.
My name is Tracy Danielson, and I was Miss Hudson for 1992. And with me this evening I have First Princess Tracy Boney, Second Princess Christina Jensen and Miss Congeniality Elsa Kramer.
Roberts and I have Nicole Conrad, Second Princess, and Kelly Chibo, Miss Congeniality.
Hello, my name is Carol Afdahl, and I am Miss Hammond, and I have with me Second Princess and Miss Congeniality, Sarah Rebard, and First Princess, Amy Uziak.
My name is Dan O'Connell. I'm 1993 Pepper Festival King, which is August 19th, 20th, and 21st. Let me introduce my court. Queen Sherry Sheehan. Princess Jenny Driscoll. Princess Marie Salzman. And Princess Van de Borst.
My name is Annika Nelson. I am here representing River Falls by myself. Our festival is in the middle of July. It's River Falls Days. Thank you.
I am the former king of North Hudson, John Cody. This is our final public appearance. I'll make it real quick here. Queen Stacy Cook. Followed by Princess Rachel Erickson, and then Andy Sheehan, and finally Princess Terry Jackson.
Thanks to all of you in the world who are here this morning. With us also this evening is the 1993 Miss Wisconsin Teen USA, Tanae Geisler. Tanae has been coaching our candidates with pageant tips, and she has a few words of wisdom.
Hi, and welcome to the pageant tonight. I hope you're all enjoying yourselves and the show that the girls worked very hard to put together. I know the judges are having a real tough time trying to figure out who to choose tonight. The girls and I have worked extensively over the past few weeks on grace and poise and public speaking and interviews, which was their biggest concern. I hope you've enjoyed all their work, and I think we all need a big round of applause.
Okay, here we go. This begins the evening gown competition of the 1994 Miss Hudson candidates. This is now. Nicole is in the Wind Ensemble and in Marching Band, where she was in the Color Guard for 3 years. She was captain last year for the Flag Twirlers. Nicole is looking forward to performing at Carnegie Hall this spring. Nicole has played for 9 years on the traveling soccer team. She was also on the high school varsity team for 2 years. She has been a Raider for 3 years. Nicole plans on attending college to become a doctor and specializing in pediatrics. Nicole is sponsored by Erickson Oil.
then, this is now. Tara has enjoyed being involved in club and high school gymnastics. She is also in summer soccer. Tara enjoys almost all outdoor activities, including mountain hiking and camping. In her leisure time, Tara enjoys drawing and pottery. She is involved in National Art Honor Society. Tara has traveled with a youth group for Habitat for Humanity in Montana and West Virginia. She had an opportunity to hike and camp in nearby mountains after working a week. Tara realized how much she loves the outdoors. Tara plans to attend college in Bozeman, Montana, to major in architecture. Tara is sponsored by Edina Realty. Very lucky. That was then. This is now. Erin's interests and hobbies include track, cheerleading, dance, camping, horseback riding, and traveling. Erin will begin training with the Civil Air Patrol soon. She flew her first airplane at age 12 in the mountains of Arizona. Erin is currently enrolled in modeling school at John Casablancas, is a member of the student council, and is the junior class secretary. Erin has narrowed her future goals to three choices: a major in aviation and become a commercial pilot, a major in business and branch out into modeling or advertising, or a major in child psychology. Erin is sponsored by St. Croix Companies. Heidi Loss. That was then, and this is now.
Hi, I'm Heidi Loss, and my parents are David and Randy Loss.
Heidi is employed by Kmart and First National Bank of Hudson. Heidi is a football and hockey cheerleader. She's on the yearbook staff and president of Future Business Leaders of America, member of the student council. Heidi likes to shop, and she is a Sunday school teacher. Heidi loves to travel, water ski, and downhill ski. Heidi has been to Canada, Mexico, and almost all 50 of the states. Heidi has a twin sister, Heather. Attending Southwest Missouri State University to major in marketing is in Heidi's plans for the future. Heidi is sponsored by First National Bank. Lisa Simpson. That was then, and this is now. Lisa is employed by McDonald's. She enjoys singing, choir, and being involved in her church youth group. Lisa is also involved in Schizos, an acting group which performs at area schools regarding teen social issues. Lisa has lived in Hudson all her life. She has become very involved in a youth group which has enabled her to travel the United States extensively. Lisa plans on obtaining a college degree in the field of elementary education and or youth ministry. Lisa is sponsored by Valley Cartage. Elizabeth Oxford. That was then, and this is now.
Hello, my name is Elizabeth Oxford, and my parents are Bob and Kathy Oxford.
Elizabeth has been employed as a gardener for the past two summers. She enjoys piano, voice, clarinet, school choirs, and band. She helps with two church youth choirs. Elizabeth has been a volunteer guide at the Octagon House Museum for the past 3 years. She likes to draw and is interested in Victorian clothing and jewelry. Traveling is also a favorite of hers. Elizabeth attended a church work camp in Kentucky two summers ago. 3 years ago, she traveled to Europe and England with her parents. Elizabeth plans to attend college and major in music education and or music performance. She would also like to travel more. Elizabeth is sponsored by St. Croix Historical Society. Desiree Moore. That was then, and this is now.
Hello, my name is Desiree Moore, and I'm the daughter of Gary and Jean Moore.
Desiree is working at St. Croix Meadows. One of her main interests is art. Desiree likes to draw, paint, and sculpt. She has played soccer for 6 years. Desiree also enjoys acting, being outdoors, and skiing. Last year, her church peers voted her as best Christian leader, and as a result, she attended a weekend retreat. That retreat was at Wolf Ridge Environmental Learning Center in Finland, Minnesota. Desiree was able to experience rock climbing, snowshoeing, hiking, and the high ropes course. Desiree plans on attending college to major in mass communications and minor in commercial art. Desiree is sponsored by Mike Standard. That was then, and this is now.
Hi, my name is Holly Kramer, and my parents are Richard and Chris Kramer.
Holly is employed at Hudson Medical Center. She enjoys being outdoors, whether it's camping, hiking, swimming, or biking. She enjoys playing soccer and being involved in summer mission trips with her church youth group. Holly enjoys art and finds all aspects of it interesting and pleasurable. She enjoys drawing the most. Holly traveled to West Virginia with her church group to work for Habitat for Humanity last summer. Holly plans to attend college at University of Wisconsin-Madison and minor in biology. She would then like to travel east and pursue a career in marine biology. Holly is sponsored by Casa de Pela. Stacy Beal. That was then. And this is now. Stacy is employed by Stillwater Kmart. She is on the volleyball team at school and played on a sand league this past summer. She loves to be busy, whether it's in school, work, or going out with friends. Stacy is always on the go. Stacy enjoyed all of the activities involved as being a candidate for the Homecoming Queen, where she was very honored to be crowned the Queen. She plans to obtain a major in elementary education and a minor in early childhood education. She would like to become an elementary education teacher. Stacy is sponsored by Hollenbach Photography. Britt Krieger. That was then, and this is now.
Hello, my name is Britt Krieger, and my parents are Jerry and Joy Krieger.
Britt is employed at Morfor. She's in volleyball, where she was captain for 2 years. Britt is a cheerleader for boys basketball. She is in marching band and wind ensemble. Britt is also active in her church youth group. As a sophomore, Britt was skiing when she fell and twisted her knee. Following her April knee surgery, she had to have physical therapy 3 times a week through the summer. Having gone through that ordeal, Britt realized she was very interested in physical therapy. She has volunteered at St. Croix Courage Center in Stillwater to work with children in an aquatic recreational physical therapy program. Britt plans on pursuing a career in physical therapy. Britt is sponsored by Morfor. Jessica Osby. Jessica is employed by AutoStop. Jessica's interests and hobbies include volleyball, swimming, water skiing, downhill skiing, and snowmobiling. She is a member of the H Club. Jessica lived with her family in Naples, Italy for 4 years and has also lived in South Carolina. Jessica plans to attend the University of Wisconsin-River Falls, where she will major in math or secondary education. Jessica is sponsored by SSG Corporation. Sales. That was then, and this is now.
Hi, my name is Karen Sales, and my parents are Debbie and Don Mason.
Karen is employed by Lavender and Lace. She enjoys playing the piano, singing, downhill and water skiing, sailing, soccer, and dancing.
Karen has also been the cheerleading captain for 4 seasons. Karen just moved here last March from Iowa City, Iowa. She literally jumped right into school life, as on Monday she started school, and Wednesday tried out for cheerleader. Karen went on a mission trip to David, Kentucky while in Iowa. That trip included bringing items to run a school. Karen's future plans are to attend college and have a great time and be content. Karen is sponsored by Lavender and Lace. Mary Rogers. That was then, and this is now.
Hi, my name is Mary Rogers, and my parents are Jim and Shirley Rogers.
Mary is employed by Hudson Subway. She likes drawing, painting, drafting, and learning about interior decorating. She also likes taking care of children. Mary enjoys traveling. She was able to do that a few years ago by visiting her brother in Texas. Recently, Mary was able to attend a Wisconsin Badger football game in Madison. Mary plans to go to a 2-year college and major in interior design decorating. Mary is sponsored by Subway. Jody Johnson, that was then, and this is now.
Hi, my name is Jody Johnson. My parents are David and Deanna Johnson.
Jody is employed by Nicholson's Drugstore. Her interests include swimming, skiing, snowmobiling, fishing, and camping. Jody also enjoys being with family and friends. In the summer of 1991, a foreign exchange student from Spain stayed with her family. Jody still corresponds with her. This past summer, Jody was an attendant in 2 weddings. Jody plans to attend college and obtain a degree in business. Jody is sponsored by Nicholson Drug. That was then, and this is now. Her interests and hobbies include cooking, baking, softball, riding bike, singing, swimming, and reading to children. She is a member of the student council. Laura went to Germany with the German class in 1992 for 3 weeks. Laura had farm chores when her family had cattle up until a year ago. Laura is listed in Who's Who for high school students. Laura plans to continue her schooling in the business area and become successful at whatever she chooses to do. Laura is sponsored by County Market. Sarah Milfeld. That was then. And this is now. Sarah is employed at McDonald's. She enjoys playing softball, volleyball, and performing as a radier. Sarah plays the flute and likes to design and sew clothing. She also makes bead earrings and necklaces. Wednesday evenings, you can find her at church teaching second graders. She is a member of Students Against Drunk Drivers and the National Honor Society. Sarah went to Washington, D.C. in the summer of 1992 with a high school marching band. That same summer, she was a national youth representative at a youth gathering in New Orleans, Louisiana. Sarah plans to attend college and major in environmental engineering. Someday, she would like to marry and have children. Sarah is sponsored by Ritzinger Eye Clinic. Sarah McGrath. That was then, and this is now. Renee is employed at Great Clips for Hair in Hudson. Her interests include being around friends and family. She was a varsity soccer and football cheerleader for 1 year. Renee is currently a varsity basketball cheerleader. She was involved in organizing the junior cheerleading clinic last summer. Renee was a rifle twirler in the color guard of the summer of in the summer, marching band for 3 years. Renee is involved in student council and an after-school all-girls choir called 4x4. Renee was nominated as a candidate for prom queen and homecoming queen. Renee's future plans include attending the University of Minnesota Duluth for 2 years
then transferring to the University of California, San Diego to finish a major in biology and a minor in elementary education. Renee is sponsored by the Hudson Star Observer. Frederick, that was then, and this is now.
Hi, my name is Beth Frederick, and my parents are Jane and Neil Frederick.
Beth is employed by Dairy Queen and is a lifeguard at the Hudson Junior High School. Beth is involved in volleyball, Great Airs, softball, student council, and color guard in marching band. Beth plays flute and piano. She loves to go whitewater rafting and working with children. Beth has traveled to Colorado and Tennessee with her youth group at church to help restore people's homes. She was also a delegate to the National Youth Gathering in New Orleans. She is looking forward to traveling New York this April with the Wind Ensemble to play at Carnegie Hall. Beth's future plans include the University of Wisconsin La Crosse to major in physical therapy. Beth is sponsored by American Family Insurance, Steve McDonald Agency. Jessica is the captain of the Hudson Great Air Dance Line. She is involved with the True Blue Times and a member of the National Honor Society. Jessica is a member of the high school swing choir. This spring, she will be part of the softball team that plans on going to state. Jessica was an umpire for 3 years and became administrator for the softball umpires of the Hudson Booster Club. She has also volunteered to work on Habitat for Humanity homes in the cities. Jessica plans on attending the University of Wisconsin-Madison to major in biochemistry and plans on focusing on genetics. Jessica is sponsored by Mudge, Porter, and Lundeen. There you have it. You've seen the 19 candidates for the 1994 Miss Hudson Court. The judges will now be escorted out to narrow their selection down to just 8 finalists. I would like again to introduce you to the 1993 Miss Hudson royalty for their final farewell. Miss Hudson and Miss Congeniality, Katie Roberts. First Princess, Martha Schultz. Second Princess, Elizabeth Bellner.
We're a little bit unorganized. Now we're just gonna Sarah, thank yous and our goodbyes. I know when I was sitting in the audience, I know how long they seem, so we try to make them short for you. First off, I'd like to thank my sponsor from last year, Hallmark Photography. If it weren't for them, I don't know what I would have done. They were an excellent sponsor. They were very encouragement, and they always wanted to help me any way they could. They were great over the summer. I was employed by them, and they were so flexible with me. I owe them a very big thank you. Thank you very much. Second, I'd like to thank my parents, my family, and Mr. and Mrs. Clem, and Mr. and Mrs. Roberts, and their family. It's unreal all the work that goes into putting up the floats and getting ready for the parades, and it's just incredible how the parents and everybody pulls together and gets the float up and down in just a couple of seconds. It's incredible. I'd like to thank my best friend, Brad. It was nice to have a familiar face in some of the parades. And I'd also like to thank Stacy Tiedemann. She was our queen mother, and she was another person that if something would go wrong or things were kind of off, she would fix them. And she was always there to help us girls in any way. I broke my crown, and she got it fixed for me. It was incredible. So I think, thank you everyone for helping me and making my ring a very special one.
First of all, I'd like to thank my sponsor, which was First Federal of La Crosse, and then I'd like to thank Peggy Pribble and the Roberts for adopting me when my parents moved to Kentucky last year. They've both been a very big help, and without them, I wouldn't have a place to live. And I'd like to also thank Stacy Tiedemann, our queen mother. She was wonderful. She helped us out many times and gave us lots of rides to lots of places. Fourth, I'd like to thank my love and my best friend, Jason McBride. He was at every single parade helping with the float, which was neat that he could take so much time to do that. And last, I'd like to thank my parents who can't be here tonight, obviously, but I love them and I miss them very much. And I know that they'll see the tape, and I know that they're with me tonight even across the miles. Thank you.
First, I'd like to thank some special people who really helped me out in making this ring a success. And my parents are on top of the list. They were great support and a lot of help with transportation of the float. Also, Stacy Tiedemann, without her, we would be lost. She let us know when to go and where to be and what time. Also, I would like to thank the Gilberts for shoring our float. And lastly, I'd like to thank my sponsor, County Market, because without them, I wouldn't be here tonight. So thank you, everyone, for your support and generosity. On behalf of Betsy, Martha, and myself, we'd like to thank the Boosters and the JCs for the float, Randy Eaton, Chevrolet for the truck to pull the float, the Chamber of Commerce, the Pageant Committee for our scholarships, Hollenbach for all the great pictures that they took, and Mike Silberg for donating his time to make a great slideshow and audio-visual planners. We have two special thank yous. If they would come up here, Stacy Tiedemann. Thank you.
And now we just have our goodbyes. This last year has been very special for me. It was a spring full of excitement, a summer filled with laughs, and fall with many memories. Kitty, Martha, and I had quite the experience. Kitty was a super queen. She always made it fun and always had a true smile on her face, even when things weren't quite right. Like when she'd forget her crown or one of her sashes, even though she had a checkoff list. But she never forgot how to enjoy herself. She and Martha made it all so much fun. Martha, you singer, you. Martha was the sophisticated one. No matter what, this princess kept her cool, even when Katie and I forgot to pick her up and left her. And left her for the Roger's Day Parade, we told her. I truly enjoyed being on the court with Martha. She always had time for enjoyment. I couldn't have had more fun in one summer than the times I did with Katie and Martha this past year. Thanks, Katie and Martha.
The problems with being taller. This last year has been filled with excitement, friendship, and unbelievable laughter. I have been honored to represent Hudson as first princess, and have been blessed by being able to be able to do that with two of my best friends. It was great going to Winter Carnival for three fun-filled days, where I had the chance to meet a lot of girls from a lot of other communities. That was wonderful, and I thank the city of Hudson for sending me there. But the best part of the summer, of course, was being with Betsy and Katie. These two girls have gotten to know me better than anyone will ever be able to. And I will never forget the times that we had together. Everything from going to very interesting Queen's teas, to making exciting new lyrics, which are mentioned, for our float music. We also simply listened, and we simply laughed with each other, which was the most fun. And I want to thank you, Betsy and Katie, for giving me the memories of a lifetime that I'll never forget.
First I want to say for the spaghetti contest, we know you guys cheated. We saw you. You weren't supposed to cut your spaghetti up, and you did. We didn't. We just got to get that straight. My memories from this last year will be sure to last me for quite a while. I really had a lot of fun with Martha and Betsy, or should I say bossy Betsy? No, she was just more like a den mother than a princess. She organized every outfit we wore, matching socks and shoes the whole nine yards. She's a great friend, and I'm really glad that we had such good times together. Martha was truly the best lyric maker, as you probably heard twice already before. She was the best lyric maker for the non-stop Down on the Love You music. It went like for the whole parade, but it was really great. Although there were some very interesting lyrics. There is memory after memory and none that I will ever forget. Betsy and Martha are great friends, and I will never forget all the good times and great laughs we shared. Thanks, you guys. You're the greatest. I'm not done yet. I would just like to add that it was truly an honor to represent the community of Hudson. I hope that I was a success in your eyes because it was an experience that I will never forget. Thank you.
Portraits and scholarships, I would like to ask the following people to join me on stage. Carol Doyle, the Community Events Coordinator for the Hudson Area Chamber of Commerce and Tourism Bureau. Stacy Tiedemann, the Queen Coordinator. Ken Larkin, Booster Club President.
Jim Henry, Hudson Area JC President, and Rick Hollenbeck from Hollenbeck Photography. The Miss Hudson Royalty is a collaborative effort of the part of three Hudson organizations that share the cost of the flow equally. The Chamber fields the request and then sends them on to the Queen Coordinator for the boosters, Stacy Tiedemann. Stacy sets up the parade schedule and the attendance schedule at special functions for the court. The boosters, usually Jerry Gilbert, coordinate with Randy Eich Chevrolet and Gilbert Motors for a vehicle for the parades. The boosters also store the float to do the upkeep and do the upkeep. As you see tonight, the other organization is the Hudson Area JCs, a leadership and training organization for men and women ages 21 to 39. Hollenbeck Photography is a strong supporter of the Miss Hudson pageant, as they donate the framed picture to each of the court. They also took the pictures of the candidates that appear in your program this evening.
My name is Jim Henry. I'm the president of the Hudson Area JCs, and on behalf of the JCs, the Chamber, and the boosters, we would like to present Miss Hudson for 1993, Katie Roberts, with a $400 cash scholarship. Okay. The first princess for 1993, Martha Schultz, with a $200 cash scholarship. To second princess for 1993, Elizabeth Belknap, with a $200 cash scholarship. And to Miss Congeniality for 1993, Katie Roberts, with a $200 cash scholarship.
At this time, Rick Hollenbeck from Hollenbeck Photography will present the portraits.
I don't know if you can see it.
At this time, each of the 1993 royalty will take their final walk. Second princess for 1993, Elizabeth Belknap. Please welcome back to the stage the candidates for 1994 Miss Hudson. As soon as I'm given the envelope, I'll announce the eight candidates that will be finalists. As I
the candidate's name, I would ask her to please step forward. Finalist number one, Sarah Milfeld. Finalist number two, Stacy Beadle. Number three, Beth Frederick. Finalist number four, Jessica Larkin. Finalist number five, Aaron Rutten. Finalist number six, Heidi Loss. Finalist number seven, Elizabeth Hawksford. And finalist number eight, Karen Sales. I'm going to ask the eight finalists to kind of center themselves on the stage, and the remainder 11 will exit to the side of the stage. At this point, each of the finalists will be asked a question from the ring of questions that I have here. They will step forward, select a card, and read it to themselves, and then I will read it aloud. First of all, I have to figure out who I'm going to talk to first. They all have their little numbers on, so that's to tell who they are. This first candidate is going to be Karen Sales. Karen's question is, what is one of your favorite childhood memories and why?
One of my favorite childhood memories is getting my new puppy, and named Sambo. And the reason that is my favorite memory is because I have loved that puppy ever since then. And even though we don't have it anymore, it's still been my favorite puppy, and that's why it was one of my favorite childhood memories was. Thank you.
Next question for Elizabeth Hawksford. Her question is, what do you think is the most important thing you've learned from participating in this pageant?
The most important thing that I've learned from this pageant is that it's been a lot of fun, and I've got to learn about the girls more, and it's just been a lot of fun getting to know them better.
Thank you. Ellie's question will be chosen now. Her question is, what's the most important issue facing teens today?
I believe the most important issue facing teens today would be peer pressure. They're faced with drugs, sex, violence, anything imaginable. It's just everything. The world is turning. Just the U.S. is faced with a lot of problems, and something needs to be done with it and solved. Thank you.
Next question for Aaron Rutten. Aaron's question is, who has been the most influential woman in your life and why?
think the most influential woman in my life would have to be my mom, because she's given me a lot of advice, and she's always there for me and always just pushing me forward and always proud of me and always gave me love. And I love her. Thank you.
Next candidate, Beth Frederick. Beth's question is, what situation or situations make you really angry and why?
One situation that really makes me angry is when people are prejudiced against other races, because I believe everyone is equal. I don't think they should be judged on how they look. That's like one of my pet peeves, when people are judged by how they look and not who they are inside and what they've done. And I think that's the main situation that would make me angry.
Stacy Beadle. Her question is, what would you do with the money if you won the lottery?
First of all, I'd go crazy and I'd go shopping. I'd go outfit for each and every day of every month. And then I'd use the rest for college and for my future. That's what I'd do with the money if I won the lottery.
Sarah's question is, what are your favorite places in Hudson?
Well, my favorite place in Hudson would probably have to be my house and my big backyard, because I always go out there and it's really relaxing. Another favorite place is probably down by the beach, so you can see the lake, and that's also relaxing. And final place would have to be school, because that's where I have most of my friends, and it's a big influence on me.
Those would have to be my favorite places. The final question goes to Jessica Larkin. Jessica's question is, if you could do anything in the world right now, what would it be?
If I could do anything in the world right now, it would be President of the United States. And I would try to help along the gun control issue, abortion issues, and all the issues facing America today. Thank you.
We have 8 candidates that have gone through their last phase of judging. At this time, the judges will be escorted back out to make their last decision as we hear from our duet of singers again. Thank you.
Enchanted door, out of every door, though it's just a
scrawny and pale, picking at my food, and lovesick like any other guy. I throw away my sweater and dress up like a dude in a dickie and a collar and a tie. If I loved you, but somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be if I loved you. Words wouldn't come an easy way round in circles I'd go. If I loved you, time and again I would try to say, all I want you to know. Long to tell you, but afraid and shy, I'd let my golden chances pass me by. Soon you'd leave me, off you would go in the mist of day, never, never. Or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony that is dutch like a knife. What's as intriguing?
Could you please start this over for a second? Thank you. Sorry about that. Yeah, that is like.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? As what's out of reach.
Humming and frequently humming like.
But this is pretty interesting, huh?
Where'd you start from? Agony, oh, the torture they teach.
Agony, oh, the torture they teach. You got that? Agony, that's agony. Where we both come in at the same time.
No, agony, misery, woe, the temper for each other.
Thank you very much.
Did you get it?
No, get the too bad. Yeah, we're going to, from the beginning this time, we warm us up, we promise.
That sounds the best.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blind and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Oh, she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach.
Or how so fatiguing as what's out of reach. Am I not sensitive, clever, or mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
Everything maidens could wish for, and why no girls be mad? You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her.
Behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach.
Maggie, I've got cuts like a knife.
Oh well, back to my wife.
Judges making the way down.
Come on down.
I was wanting to say that. Let's bring all the 19 candidates back out to the stage where we will start off with the talent award. Schultz, last year's talent recipient.
Do you have the talent? Hey, he's got the talent. We'll get it.
Tonight, the talent winner is Elizabeth Oxford.
For the purpose of a special reading, I would like to ask Katie Roberts to the stage.
Hold on. Thanks a ton.
Just a minute, we're still searching for her reading.
There it is.
Okay, now that I'm out of breath. All I remember from last year is that I really didn't hear it because I was so nervous. I know how you guys are feeling. But if you really listen to the words, it makes a lot of sense. The reading is called, and the winner is, it's kind of tradition. And the winner is, oh how your heart will pound. The moment you've been waiting for has finally come around. But stop. Suppose that you don't win. Suppose you don't get the fame. But it isn't the winning that counts so much. It's how you play the game. Each one is a winner, and you've won the greatest gifts that God can give. You've won friends and the love to cherish. That's why people want to live. But if you win the crown and the roses, but not the friends and love, you're a loser, not a winner. Just ask the Lord above. Your friends and love will last forever and a day. Yes, forever and a day. But the crown and the roses will rust and crumble and quickly fade away. Your moms and dads are seated here with teardrops in their eyes. Their hearts are beating just like yours to hear who won the prize. To them, we are each a little bit of heaven. To your friends, you are the same. To be happy and successful, you don't need to have the fame. So when they announce the winner, it should be a real thrill. For if you don't win the roses, remember, one of your best friends will.
Miss Congeniality is chosen by her fellow candidates. They are saying that she is a wonderful friend and a fun person to be with. After I make the announcement, she will then step forward and be crowned and given her sash by the upcoming Miss Congeniality, Katie Roberts, and then take her first walk. Can I have the Miss Congeniality envelope? Miss Congeniality from 1994 is Lisa Simpson. Step forward to buck this lion. The 11 other candidates will form one big line behind them as we go on to announcing the princesses and the queen. Ready? Presenting the second princess will be Elizabeth Belknap. Second princess, 1994, Heidi Voss. First Princess, 1993, will have the honor of crowning her successor. First Princess, 1994, Elizabeth Oxford.
between their few quick things. First of all, we'd like to thank Mr. John Potter and the Tip Center staff. We would again like to thank all of the candidates, their sponsors, and other area businesses that also made donations to make this event. Pictures will be taken by Hollenbeck Photography in the Terrace Room immediately after Ms. Hudson is crowned. Please join me in adjoining to the River Room for the reception after Ms. Hudson is announced. Thank you. You have been a wonderful audience. And now, Katie Roberts, Ms. Hudson, 1993, has the proud opportunity to say that Jessica Larkin is Ms. Hudson. Reception in the River Room. And,